Welcome back to the Pig Trail. We are joined now by our Hogville basketball insider, Kevin McPherson. Kevin, thank you for joining us. And I know there's been a lot of shakeup so far in the offseason for Arkansas basketball in such a short time. And I want to start by talking about some 2022 in-state recruits. Arkansas is doing an incredible job getting guys into their program.
Yeah, that's right. You know, the transfer portal, and we know Musselman's an expert at that, a transfer portal wizard. But, you know, high school recruiting and high school player and prospects, that moves a little more slowly. Arkansas's already got one in-state commitment for the class of 2022 and four-star Joseph Pinion. I got to see him play with the 17 and under Arkansas Hawks on Saturday in Memphis against a good program, Hoop City Basketball Club. And, you know, he basically, the way they did it was they played back-to-back games on Saturday, and the players on each team basically played two quarters in each game so that everybody could get a, you know, get some opportunity to measure themselves against some of the best players in the region. And in roughly four quarters spread over two games, Pinion finished with 24 points, hit four three-pointers, pulled down 16 rebounds, eight assists, three blocked shots. And so 6'6 wing out of Marlton had a really strong season, led that team to the state finals in 4A. But when you go into grassroots level, you're going to measure yourself now against competition that may be a little more steep. And that's what I saw on Saturday. So Pinion really showed well for himself. Again, committed to Arkansas. But there's so much I like about him because of his high basketball IQ. He doesn't force things. In other words, he's not chasing numbers. He just plays the game the right way, and he's got so much talent. His pull-up game, not only from three, but getting in the mid-range, he can get all the way to the basket. And three-block shots, you know, it really speaks to his both sides of the ball ability, but really a big showing by Pinion on Saturday.
Now, a lot of these in-state recruits, you mentioned Pinion, Nick Smith Jr., they're going to be very happy that Eric Musselman is now here to stay in Arkansas after signing a new contract, and also someone leaving the program, Corey Williams going to Texas Tech. Thoughts on the staff leaving, but Mus staying?
Yeah, well, if you look at Mus, I mean, not only is it the transfer portal, we talked about the high school recruiting, that 2020 class he brought in, Moses Moody, one and done. You saw what Devo Davis and Jalen Williams did in the second half of the season. Two big reasons why Arkansas went on that winning streak, ended up finished ranked in the top 10 and made it to the Elite Eight. So we know what he's done in state recruiting-wise on the high school level. So anytime your coach gets a raise, that signals that the program is strong. It's not just about the one season where they did great, but now you're looking at some longevity with the coaching staff. Now, it is interesting that his buyout in 1 year's time goes from $7.5 million to $2 million, so we'll keep an eye on that. But at the same time, I think it's only encouraging for recruiting at all levels when a coach resigns. You know, Corey Williams was a big part transitioning to the assistant who was on the initial staff. It was the first hire Musselman made. Now he's at Texas Tech. He was the lead recruiter for that 2020 high school class. He's also the lead recruiter for Chance Moore, the top 100 ESPN player in the 2021 class that signed in the early period. So it'll be interesting to see the dynamics. David Patrick, the associate head coach, is a recruiter, very effective on the high school recruiting levels. We'll see how Arkansas continues to have a seamless effort recruiting that part of it, because we're talking so much about transfer portal this part of year. We don't want to forget about the high school recruiting. It's still important for any school that's playing at a high major level.
Well, let's focus on that transfer portal, because they've made a lot of moves, the Razorbacks have, adding guys like Audis Tony into the mix and Chris Likes from Miami. But you're saying there might be one more transfer coming in, likely?
Yeah, you know, I thought it might happen last week, but I think there's another one coming very soon. And I also think there may be another departure. We know that Moses Moody's declared for the NBA draft. We know that Ethan Henderson and Desi Sills have moved on. I think at least one more player is going to enter the portal on the current team. But I expect we'll hear a name soon on a fourth transfer addition. And, again, if another player is moving out, that will open up another scholarship again, because they have one open now. So if another player is leaving, that'll be total of two. If they add a fourth guy, they'd still have one to fill. We'll see if Musselman holds on to that spot for midterm or later on, or if he looks to add actually a total of two more. Don't want to get the math too confusing, but I do think at least one's coming on board soon.
It's the off season, but it's always a very busy season, especially for Arkansas basketball. Thank you, Kevin, for joining us. Kevin McPherson, our Hogville basketball insider. We have more Pig Trail Nation news right after the break.